Well, as we get ready for third down, let's go back and recap here. The sack on the first play of this drive, that threw a wrench in what they were trying to accomplish because they were compelled to throw the ball on second down. A running play was not in the works. And that incompletion set up another passing down here on third and long.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means he'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now the Rams will signal for a timeout, their second. So as they take it over, we step aside. And some secondary help here for the defense of the nickel on third and long. Back to throw. Lucas. He's going to drop this one down for Chubb. And he gets this only to the 44-yard line. Not near enough to keep the drive alive. They get 13, but it's not nearly enough. And it'll be fourth down. Here's Jamie Gillen now as he's on to punt for Cleveland. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Taylor now returning it. That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time. And out will come the offense as they take over. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And two interceptions already here in this first half. That's got to affect him a little bit, right? He's got to be thinking about it.
He's got to be thinking about it, but most of the good ones, they find a way to put it aside. They're not happy about it by any stretch of the imagination. They find a way to put it aside and continue to play their game.
Can he put it aside? Let's find out. He's going to let this go for the end zone. And this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown, LA. A big play there. His second touchdown of the game and his ninth on the year. And the Rams strike quickly here for 6 points. Extra point right down the middle. And it's now 14 to nothing. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. From the 6. And he'll take it a yard or so past the 20, call it the 21. The Browns drive about to get started. And they are losers of 2 straight coming into this Thursday night game. Is it more difficult, CD, when you take a losing streak into a quick turnaround game like this?
It certainly is, because you don't get time to work on the issues that you've had throughout the season that have caused you to have the record that you're having. You can't really get those set. So now you're trying to minimize those and maximize what you've been doing well. And I remember a game recently where one of the assistant coaches said to the head coach, "Forget our running back rotation. This guy has a hot hand," and they rode him to a victory. Those are things you have to look out for in games like this.
And he's brought down after a very nice gain.
I know that play went to the left side, and that's what it was designed to do, an outside handoff there. But how about the whole offensive line being involved? Seal the left side where the play was going, what they call play side. But how about on the back side? Just taking care of business to make sure no one can get there and disrupt it.
Is the biggest key the left tackle?
Without a doubt. Control that edge. Get out there. You want that left.
Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And the Ramsons are going to take over at their own 28-yard line. He's had a fantastic rookie season, made a lot of lovely throws, but that wasn't one of them.
Well, we got to give him one, don't we? I mean, with the year he's having, a lot easier for he and his teammates to accept that throw, because for the most part, what they've seen, it's been pretty sensational.
And they'll wind up getting this to the 37, gain of 9.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking. But the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard. Crunch, crunch, crunch. They just do get the playoff as he'll look to throw. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Well, that's a defensive coordinator's got to be happy with that result. They took away all options downfield and forced the incompletion.
They tried the throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's third and one. Now a handoff as they run left side. Finding some room at midfield. And finally down at the 36-yard line. 69 yards for him on the ground so far tonight as he has been terrific in this first half. So a first and 10 upcoming from Browns territory now at the 36. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower his center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
Now a handoff looking right. And he'll be tackled at the 23 after a gain of three.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out. And they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a three-yard gain.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And nowhere to run on the interior of that defensive line. He'll get back only to the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. Coming up at the half, a reminder, we go back to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman. He'll have a look back at our first half, as well as a look ahead to what's coming up later this weekend. Now here's a handoff out of the gun. And he will be very close to a first down, but I see the closed fist of the referee, and that means fourth down. It's a gain of seven, and that's going to make it fourth down.
Less than a yard.
It's a quarterback sneak.
But when you do call quarterback sneak, you don't mind if your quarterback's a little bit on the vertically challenged side, do you? Because he's just going to hide behind his big guys up front and be able to surge forward and pick up the first down.
First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. Three tight ends are out there. And to give this time to the tailback. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
Defensively, we always know that he is tough in run support, and I think the way that he gets there is he understands what an offense is going to do before the ball's even snapped. A great job of scouting prior to the game, then reading, reacting, and taking the right path to the ball carrier.
And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. A great play there. His 17th touchdown now on the season. And the Rams are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Well, that is a running back who is not about to go down easily. He fought his way through the contact until the seas opened up for him.
Yeah, and that's a run born out of ferociousness. He took on that initial contact and in his mind just screamed, out of my way, and kept right on going and wound up turning it into a big play.
And the next-gen stats shows us the tale of how much yardage he was able to pick up after the initial contact. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he will make it to the 20-yard line and no further. The Browns drive about to get started. And with a little under a minute remaining, they may try to put something together here just to try to cut into that deficit. Going up top. And it'll be incomplete. Good job staying with him defensively, and it'll bring up second down.
I know he wants to get his team back in the game, but a 50-50 ball right there that maybe was a little questionable.
Yeah, he's pretty lucky to get that one back. I think that sometimes these quarterbacks play with a lot of confidence that borders on arrogance, and that can put your team in some dutch.
Yeah, especially maybe want to look at some safer routes after the interception he had that ended their last drive.
Second and 10. Off play action, Lucas. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off around the 41. That time defensively looked like they showed quite a bit of pressure, but backed off, and it proved fruitful to get the pick.
He went through all of his rules about getting rid of the ball quickly because he read blitz. He saw all those people stacked at the line of scrimmage, and then they fooled him by dropping into coverage. Now he's ready to get rid of the ball fast, but guess what? Too many defenders out there. Exactly as you described, an interception.
And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Now the Browns will use the first of their three timeouts as they'll stop him with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. Now it's second and 9. And he stopped immediately there. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. It looks like a nickel set now for the Browns on third down. To throw. And all this is taken in one-handed. What a catch.
And in a lot of ways, that catch is expected. Red zone presence, and that one was realized there. You've got to find your tight end in that situation.
First and goal at the 3-yard line.
The chance to really cap off a big first half here as they come up on first and goal. Try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Rams.
A great effort there. His second TD of the game and 18th of the year.
And the Rams continue to pull away here in this first half.
The call is to go for one and kick the extra point. It's good, and they stretch their lead to 28-0 now. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone.
And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The Browns drive about to get started. And they'll take over with just 18 ticks remaining. They go back to the air here after the... And the Rams got him! They bring him down! The Browns will quickly use their third and final timeout as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. Quite a ways here, facing second and 19. Operating from the gun, Lucas. It's caught by Hooper. And he gets it to the 30 when it's all said and done. So we've come to halftime after a very one-sided beginning to this one. As we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? All right, Coach, thanks very much. Fine work as always as we welcome you back for quarter number three. The Browns going to see the football first, but they trail here as we resume play on EA Sports. Takes it at the 7. And he'll be brought down right on the chalk of the 20. The Browns drive about to get started. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
Yeah, they're down big right now. So as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained, maybe calm their whole team down and find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down big, you're being shut out. Let's see if this is the drive that kind of kickstarts them.
They'll come up second and 6 now from the 24. From the gun, Lucas.
He finds his man, complete. It's McKenzie. Short completion, just 4 yards. And they're going to have a third down.
I wouldn't be surprised to see the next step in utilizing this position is to actually utilize more of a scat back in this spot. Because we saw the catch there, right? He made it, but he's a bigger, stronger guy. Maybe not quite as elusive as maybe someone else you would put
in. Yeah, didn't get the big yardage there. You might have a smaller back.
They'll run for it. Here's Chubb. Chubb will have the first down and much more. And all the way up to the 46. 45 yards rushing for him now. He's only carried the ball 4 times.
Obviously an important run to avoid the 3 and out on your own side of the field.
Shows a lot of faith in that offensive unit, doesn't it? That you want to run the ball in that situation. Pick up the first down. Also helps out your defensive guys a little bit, too. Allows them to get at least one more series of downs in order to get some rest.
And that is knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
But the passing windows are just not there. And that's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on that one as it brings up a 3rd and 10.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
to throw on third down. Lucas
going out wide, finds Chubb. And they'll get this across the midfield stripe, but still winding up short of the first down. They do get 7 out of that, but not enough to prevent a fourth down. Here's Jamie Gillen now, as he's on to punt for the fourth time tonight.
And a great job on special teams to down it, as this will be marked out inside the 5-yard line.
That punt was near perfection as it checked up inside the 5-yard line. You never know where these things are going to go, do you?
No, what was it? You got a John Heisman quote about that,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, he said the football is roughly a prolate spheroid, which means it's going to bounce funny, and you never know where it's going to end up.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. From the gun, he'll hand this off. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
And that run there does nothing but juice up the guys who are moving the football. I mean, if you're an offensive lineman, people running it, actually the guy calling plays, you're almost jumping up and down in jubilation, aren't you?
Yeah, now you've got options on second down.
And big-time options. You might want to think about play action and try and get something cheap right here over the top.
8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and 2. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. He's going to air one out. He's got a man complete. Touchdown, LA. A big play there. 8 yards, and the Rams open the lead up to 34-0. I don't think there's anyone who could possibly doubt how fast he could run in the open field, but if there were, he silenced those thoughts there.
Well, in this league where coordinators worry so much about drawing up the right routes, blocking assignments, misdirections and stuff, they have these precise arrows and movements. Sometimes the best plays just come from the schoolyard where you look at your fastest guy and say, go long, go get it, big man.
And the next-gen stats are going to tell the story, and wow, what a story it is. Nearly a full 23 miles an hour. One of the fastest plays on record, folks. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And able to take it past the 20 a little bit, but no further. A flag in there as well. Let's see what this is. So now factoring in the face mask, here's first and 10. They give the Chubb out of the gun. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. 56 yards rushing for him now on just 6 carries to this point.
That's pretty much meat and potatoes right there, wasn't it? Just go right at him and let your big horse charge up the middle. Not too fancy there, was it?
Nothing fancy at all, challenging that defense. And on that go-around, the offense won the challenge. And now the Rams are going to halt things as they want a timeout. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. A run for Nick Chubb. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Ram territory. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
They lost 4 there, and it's third down.
You've got to figure the further they fall behind, the more you think that they'll get away from the run. They're trying to stick with it, but the results, they just aren't there.
These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on third down. Looking to throw, Lucas. And he gets it to his running back, Nick Chubb. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
There's a nice pickup right there. And after watching that play, I'm thinking about all the lost opportunities that they've had so far in this game. But right now, just focus on continuing to move the ball the way they did on the last play.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10. He'll let this go for the end zone. And that is incomplete.
Well, we saw that he had a lot of success last week throwing the football, but that hasn't translated to this week. But with his team behind, I don't expect him to back off. I expect him to keep firing.
Now they return to the ground game. Chubb. They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a third and 8 coming up.
He was hoping to get to the edge, but they did a really nice job of forcing him back inside. That's excellent fundamental defensive football. Don't let them outside where they can really stretch your defense.
So third down now. They need the 27-yard line for a first. Space to run past the 20, and he's going to get it down to the 14-yard line.
Man coverage on the left side, so I really like the design of this play because they opened up the field and brought their tight end the other way on a crossing route. That's a lot of ground to cover if you're a defender. I've been there before, unable to stay with his man there.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Dumps this to his running back, Chubb. Touchdown, Browns! Nick Chubb, his 11th touchdown of the year. And the Browns able to get this one back to within at least some measure of respectability. Coaches must really like to see that from the quarterback because he's had the interceptions in this game, but they're able to connect on the touchdown pass.
And teammates love to see that because they know that they miss blocks during a game, but they come back and make them later on. They miss tackles, right? They miss making plays. But the spotlight is magnified on your quarterback. And when he stands up to the pressure and comes back and throws a touchdown pass after throwing some picks earlier, they feel great about that guy.
And likewise for him personally, as a rookie quarterback, has to give him more confidence. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. Still well in control of this ball game despite giving up that touchdown a moment ago. They'll come out throwing here on first down. He'll get that complete to the tight end, Harris. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5.
A gain of 5 brings up second and 5.
And they'll run on the inside handoff. And for one of the first times all night, he is going to go nowhere as they bury him behind the line.
A 2-yard loss brings up third and 7.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. He gets it complete to Harris. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line.
And that's well executed there on third down. And I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field, right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw. And they hooked up there for a first down.
And he's out of bounds, but not before a big pickup that time on what's going to wind up being the final play of the third quarter. Back now here on EA Sports. It's the Rams out in front here. They've got control of the football as well as we get set for the fourth quarter. So a first and 10 upcoming from Browns territory now at the 39-yard line. Back to throw here. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Picked up by Jeremiah Owusu-Koramoah. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Browns defense has a touchdown. This game's still fairly well in hand, but I think now you go conservative, don't you? Go into your shell and just run the football?
I think you have to, but you also have to tell your backs, make sure you're really protecting the football because you're going to run into a stacked defensive front, which is why they were throwing the football before, trying to make sure they just get their backs, you know, really beat up in that situation. Now, good luck to them.
Taken at the goal line. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And that pick six a moment ago doesn't change things too much. They still seem pretty comfortable with a three-possession fourth quarter lead. After the pick six, they go right back to the air. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he'll be out of bounds near the 30. In fact, right on the 30.
Well, how about this aggressive approach? Got the lead, fourth quarter, continuing to throw the football. Are you thinking about Super Bowl 51? Atlanta had the lead against New England, and they ended up giving it up.
I was going to say, don't say it, but you did say it.
I did, didn't I?
Yeah, anybody watching in Atlanta, our apologies. So first and 10 now from the 30. Hands it off out of the gun. And he's going to have a Rams first down as he's got this up to the 40-yard line. It carries like that. That's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better way to close out a game than to tap those mastodons you have up front and say, guys, keep pounding them. Let's keep the ball, keep their offense on the sidelines, and let's close this one out.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. To throw. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked up by Jeremiah Owusu-Koramoah. And the Browns are going to have great field position here as this is returned just shy of midfield. Oh, you just kind of feel for him right now. Four interceptions, and you can almost see through his face mask. There's a lot going on in between the ears.
There certainly is, and probably way too much, because now he's probably doubting himself a little bit, wondering what adjustments he has to make. But here's what he needs to do. Get through this game. Go to the press conference, meet it head on, and show your teammates you're ready to shoulder what happened today, and you'll be ready for the next game.
And if he can do that as a rookie, that's a great sign of maturity. 19, 19, 19. To throw on second down, Lucas. He finds his man, complete. It's Jacobs. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35.
Number six. A gain of 13 yards.
On first down, they'll run with Chubb. Runs over him. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 74 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game.
That's a nice run right there, able to get to the outside. And so many times defenses say, okay, we've got you hemmed in. But if you're running the football, at least you know where everyone is coming from. You don't have to worry about the backside at all. That allows you to run with a little bit more confidence as you traverse down the field.
No dice this go around. He's hit behind the line and taken down. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
I think this offense, specifically this running game, they're going to have to find a way to turn the page because they haven't found a way to run it effectively thus far, and it's cost them.
Looking to throw on second down. Lucas eluding the pressure right. And he's going to lose a yard or two. Taken down behind the line. It's It's a loss of a yard, so they'll wind up crediting him with a sack, and it brings up third down.
Remember, throughout my career here in defensive coaches always say, guys, you've got to earn the right to rush the passer. They put themselves in a great spot with this big lead, and they know they've got to throw the ball.
These pass rushers have to be salivating. It is pin your ears back time indeed. Now a third down throw, but it misses the target, incomplete.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Rams are going to take possession of the turnover on downs. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line.
Been a very strong performance for them, really, on both sides of the football. The turnover on downs, the most recent example, and now, obviously, they're in a great spot here.
Yeah, if you're over on the bench right now, you're shaking hands with your teammate, you're hugging him, give him a little dap. Been a big, big performance for them.
It got his man complete. Touchdown, LA. A great play there. An 80-yard touchdown. And the Rams add on to their lead, and they are also closing in on a fifth straight victory. I think it's fair to say there's nothing that gets a crowd to its feet quite like a big play, and that was something special there. Boy, was he moving.
And that's the kind of play where you have to kind of catch your breath afterwards, so just give me a second here, because when he shifted into high gear, he was an absolute blur out there. No substitute for speed. We talk about that all the time. The evidence was right there.
And the next-gen stats are going to tell the story. And, wow, what a story it is. Nearly a full 23 miles an hour. One of the fastest plays on record, folks.
Fielded just outside the goal line. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Browns drive about to get started.
And they unfortunately are staring at a mini losing streak developing, trailing here in the fourth quarter. This would be their third straight defeat.
On first and 10, Lucas, incomplete. Another pass attempt, another incompletion, and they're just a little over 100 yards passing here in this game, so defensively, pretty good job.
Definitely, because they were never really able to get the ball in the hands of their playmakers, so a lot of credit to the defensive game plan and especially the execution.
He's going to loft one deep left side here, and that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. On third down, Lucas. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge, and that's good enough for a first down.
Well, this game is certainly pretty well over. They go ahead and mark it in the win column. But as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball all over the place against them, gets big yardage, and puts points on the board. They have pride, too, on that side of the ball.
Again, he'll drop to throw. Drops it off for Chubb. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40.
Maybe a frustration penalty there because he's picked them apart.
They've tried their best to get to him and haven't done it successfully. A penalty as a result of that hit there.
So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense, first and 10.
You better be ready. Don't be scared of it.
Back to throw again. Throwing left side, it's complete. Touchdown!
You're on the run.
A great effort there. His sixth touchdown of the season.
And the Browns get a small measure of revenge as they cut into this fourth quarter deficit.
Point after, right down the middle. And that'll cut the lead back down to 21. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line.
And it would appear that the open week a week ago came just at the right time as they have dominated the proceedings here into this fourth quarter.
Now a deep ball here, hauled in just past the 50. And take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
Offensively, another big chunk of yardage, Charles, but defensively, they had all this talk about trying to limit explosive plays. They have not been able to do that.
They discussed it all week, but they haven't been able to execute it at all, haven't been able to find a way to slow down this offense. They're seeking answers and not coming up with any.
They go play action here on first down. Going for the deep ball. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And he's out of bounds. Almost gets to the 10. A big connection on that one. 34 yards.
Even with the big lead here in the fourth, it still bombs away. And frankly, it's working. Why should they stop? Go ahead and keep firing away and gaining those yards.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's going to take this one in for a Rams touchdown. A 12-yard touchdown run.
And the Rams add on to their fourth quarter lead, and they are on their way to improving to 8-2.
Extra point splits the uprights, and that'll increase their lead to 28.
49, Browns 21.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further.
In this position, trying to get back into the game, teams are looking for a spark from their special teams. That's not what they got, though. They got a setback, and they have a long field to cover if they want to try and put points on the board.
The Browns drive about to get started.
We certainly had a sense coming in here that these guys were in for a tough one on the road. That has been how this ball game has played out. They trail big as we continue on now here in this fourth quarter.
So they will accept the penalty and move forward. So now a fresh set of downs, first and 10 after roughing the passer. Back to throw, Lucas. Throw left side, complete. That's Jacobs. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. So the Browns in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. On first down, Lucas. He'll get this to Chubb out of the backfield. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down.
Hey, check back 11, check back 11. Watch the run, watch the run.
Now the Rams will signal for a timeout, their second. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down. Looking to throw, Lucas. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. Picked off at the 25.
First down.
certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now three interceptions in this ballgame.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning, threw 28 his rookie year.
Remember my pockets in a jar, I couldn't build a new chick. They say that truly love is paper. You see that's a meal. That's why you catch all my brothers ballin' and shooting no bricks. Hold up, check me out. Hold up. I think the tables done turned. Forget the bridges we done built. This time I let them all burn. They tried to kill me out. Well, now it's the word. I bring it paper, paper, paper from the first to the first. They count me out.
Yeah, yeah.
Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling. What they say,
on God.
Only ever care about one thing.
Ching, ching, ching.
Cha-ching, cha-ching, rackets, rackets.
Hit the bank.
Ba-bang, ba-bang, put you in your place. Wait, they done got me started. Without me, it's not a party.
No.
Ma, he got it rocking. We bring havoc to your lobby. Tristan, he got shoddy. They gon' copy cause we poppin'. Blues up in my wallet. If I like it, then I cop it. Hold up, check me out.
Hold up.
I think the tables done turned. Forget the bridges we done built. This time I let them all burn.
They tried to kill me out.
Well, now it's the word.
I
bring it
word.
Paper, paper, paper from the first to the first.
They
count me out.
Yeah, yeah.
Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling.
Oh,
count me out.
Nah, nah.
It all begins.
Right here.
Right now. Catch me if you can.
Gotta make the right decision, or it might just be my last. People view everything different when you touching on the back. What you see as good intentions is for clout and hit is mad. You can never be yourself, you carry, gotta wear a mask. They be pulling at you, grabbing at you, pop up trying to change you. I built my own foundation and there ain't no rearranging. Moving careful every day is exactly how I play this. Not looking for number one, but that's exactly how I'm pacing. I got choices, I'm getting opinions from so many. So I can get up away from all the noise. Too many people tell me what I should do. I take it and laugh. They not knowing if I mess up, I can end up falling flat. If I write a bad tweet, lagging in my whole street. If I give them what they want, then I'm gonna be broke in a week. If I tell my baby no, she might get it from the street. If I'm not tough on my son, he might grow up to be weak. What do I do? I'm new to having cameras in my face. What do I do to keep getting the love from my state? What do I do to keep the money coming in? What do I do? Writing it till I need another pen. Gotta make the right decision, or it might just be my last. People view everything different when you touching on the back. What you see as good intentions is for clout and hit is mad. You can never be yourself, you carry, gotta wear a mask. They be pulling at you, grabbing at you, pop up trying to change you. I built my own foundation and there ain't no rearranging. Moving careful every day is exactly how I play this. Not looking for number one, exactly how I'm placed. Feel like Jesse Owens, cause I'm taking off with the race. Put the metal to his mouth, retain his tongue, hold the brace. But I'm all about the beast until the sucker hit a make. Oh man, eat man, your performance kinda shaky. I'm prepared for the fame, I like that cops, I'm really like me. But I'd be lying if I said I didn't cry at least once a week. Cause I'm so blessed with no stress, all the way taking off of me. Head in the clouds and I smile like no grandma watching me. My dream came true. I'm loving all these cameras in my face. I never knew that I would get the love from my state. Stay with the blue, always keep the money coming in. Ain't nothing new, writing it till I need another pen. Gotta make the right decision, or it might just be my last. People view everything different when you touching on the back. What you see as good intentions is for clout and hit is mad. You can never be yourself, you carry, gotta wear a mask. They be pulling at you, grabbing at you, pop up trying to change you. I built my own foundation and it ain't no rearranging. Moving careful every day is exactly how I play this. Not looking for number one, but that's exactly how I'm facing.
It's just a little hit for the summer. Big deal. Here I go, I'm jumping out of green balloon. Geronimo, man, I ride big wheels. 24, and I let the pain drip like the hose. Whoa,
big cars.
Suicide goes like God scores.
You don't know my life is hard.
Make me wake up in the morning. Chinchilla for the wizard. Cotton sweater clip. Queen Latifah, Rego, living single.
minute. Miss me with that, put that. I'll be back in a minute with my good vibes, good vibes. Man, I lie. Good signs and good. Just I got my reclining and watching. See her on the Wi-Fi. I cannot just go away. Can you bring me back to my old way? Tell my mom and dad I'm praying for some better days. Only good vibes Friday to Friday. I'm looking for a highway to get Mondays. And I'm so up there, I might be going sideways. Kamikaze Sundays, leaning on my Mondays. Baby face like Usher, I just want it my way. Relax, I've been gone for a minute. Told you I'd be back, just chill for a minute. Last time I checked, you was on for a minute. Miss me with that, put that, I'll be back in a minute with my.
Subconscious mind that I have only seen in dreams of my unconscious mind. My dreams unrefined, spring the mind, a state of mind that make it seem this lucky life of mine is pre-designed. And if it is, then thank the Lord, cause that's the mastermind.
Listen, yes, Lord.